First of all, I gotta get... Well, I didn't get my markers. Let me go get my... Got to get my marker. But we're going to plant some seeds today. I want to wet some dirt though before I put seeds in there. And it is supposed to rain today, tomorrow, and the next day, so it ought to do some good. And I didn't find my spinach seeds. I don't think I used it all. Well, I may have, I don't know. This package is empty. May have to wait on that one. But what I'm going to do is plant my pepper seeds from that bell pepper that I cooked. But I need to mark it so I'll know what they are. And it's green bell pepper. Mark each one before I even plant anything. As many seeds as I got, I'm going to fill these three pots up with that bell pepper. Whew. Some of you might have been wondering, well, what did she mean by what she was going to do with that aloe vera that I had broke off? Nothing goes to waste around here. Now, as you know, when you plant slices of tomato and stuff, the little bit of pulp and stuff that's around that tomato helps keep the seeds moist, and that's what I'm going to do with this aloe vera. I'm putting the aloe vera underneath the seeds. I'm just slicing it in half. And it should help keep the seeds moist so they'll germinate faster. And I'm going to leave some of them on the pepper plant. I mean, you know, the pepper itself, the core of the pepper, because that also helps germinate. It keeps the seeds moist. And there's going to be a ton of peppers that will come up from this. And I will have to pull them out. And place them in other spots. But hey, that's okay. I'll pull them out and I'll plant them somewhere else. But I want the peppers. And I'll plant this one in a pot that I've got over here. Now all we gotta do is cover them seeds up. And you can do a lot of other seeds this way too. And I wanted to get them in the dirt today because it's supposed to rain the next couple of days, and that's going to help tremendously on getting these germinated and getting them to grow. But look at my yellow squash. Don't they look good? They're coming right along, y'all. But I'm gonna come over here and plant these two the same way in this bucket. I mean, you don't have to cut a shiver of it, you know, a small piece. So one piece of aloe vera will go a long way. And I'm gonna put the rest of this, because look at all the seeds. Look at all the seeds still in this. Those seeds come up, it's going to give me all the pepper plants I'm going to need. That's green bell pepper. And I'll need to mark it so I don't forget. Oops, that broke. That plastic is dry rotting. Get another one of these. You know, the pieces from the totes are the best to use as markers because they don't dry rot as fast as the other. I need to get those rugs off of the gas pump, gas tank. Storm in the shed or somewhere. Let me see if I've got, can find any. Oh, I need something to put these on. I need to find some spinach seed. I don't think I used all of it. Leeks. Thyme. Catnip. I should have went through all this before, but sometimes I never know what I'm going to plant till I get out here and start messing. I got everything but what I'm looking for. That's a hybrid spinach. Maybe I could put some of that over there. See how that'll work. We'll try it. These green buckets, I'm going to put spinach, lettuce, all kind of greens in. So I'll be able to remember because this will be my green bucket. But I'm going to do my seeds the same way. I'm going to cut my aloe vera. Just slice it in half, lay it in my bucket with the gooey side up. And the gooey side is where I'm going to put my seeds. And I don't know if you can see it. See if I can move it over this way. If you can see that aloe vera that's in that bucket. I'm going to put my seeds right on top of it. And this is a salad mix. It has lettuce, all kind of greens and stuff in it. So it's a salad mix. That right there. Whoops. Then I'm just going to cover it up slightly. But that little bit of moisture from that aloe vera, we'll keep the seeds moist. And I'm going to do this one down here the same way. Back this camera up. I'm just slicing this aloe vera, opening it up, and putting the gooey side up. Now, if you don't have aloe vera, don't worry about it. But if you do, this is a good way to utilize some of it. And I'm just coming over to this side, and I'm going to do the same thing. Slice open my aloe vera. Kind of making a like a pad for your seeds to lay on. A moist pad. That's all it is. Ugh. Got it all in my hands. And then I just throw that seed right on top of the sliced aloe vera. And it'll stick right to it. And you know what? I think I'm going to put some of my spiced pepper down in the bottom. Whew, I'm sweating already, y'all. It's hot out here. But I wanted to get this done before it rains. I don't know if you can see this bottom one. No, you can't. But I've already got something come up in there voluntarily. But this is that hot pepper blend. And I'm going to put this one on the other side. And it should help with the germination of these seeds. And with this hot weather we have, it should help the seeds stay moist to help them germinate. It especially helps the tomato seeds, I know. And I'm gonna put jalapenos in the middle one, I think. It's gooey, gooey, gooey. So remember to bring you a paper towel. If you don't, your seeds will stick to your fingers. Now let's see if I can find a marker. And I think my okra's coming up. It's popped through the ground in that little blue pool. I'll mark this one on this side. Well, I'll know the bottom pots are hot pepper. I need to cut me some more, I can't find my pocket, y'all. I need to cut me some more markers. Let's see, I think we've got pretty much all of this side planted now. Just looking around to see if there's any other pots that needed to be planted. I think I got them all planted on this side. So, I guess we can go around to the other side. Get this tripod. Oop! I'm sorry about that, y'all. It landed on my head. It landed on my head. And I've got to put flowers out in these cinder blocks. And I've got all of that seed stuff in the the shed. Sorry about that, y'all. But went and got me a canary yellow melon and a sweet dumpling squash that I'm gonna plant over here, I think. I'm not sure which where I want to put what. That's a sweet dumpling squash. And I don't know if I should plant a watermelon around here or not. It's liable to go crazy. But this is the canary yellow watermelon. And I think I might put it on this side. Whew. I'm sweating, y'all. I had a eggplant over here last year. I think I'm going to put this here this year. And it's already got it had roots coming out the bottom of this little pot. And I don't have my gloves on. Let's see. Gotta mark them, y'all. Canary yellow melon. And this is the sweet dumpling squash, I think. Whoops. And I need to put one of my tomato plants there. Don't know what I'll put down there. I think there was two in there. I probably should have separated them. I didn't even think about that. There was two, I think. Maybe not. Maybe it was just one. What did it look like to you? Let me see if I can find one of those tomato plants. I got a gold medal tomato that I'm going to put in here, and I'm going to put the bottom one with another sweet dumpling squash, I think. It's already got roots coming out the bottom, as little as that plant is. And this is the gold, what did I say, the gold medal tomato. Probably need a tomato plant there. There's actually three right there. I might be able to pull one of them out later. Whew. See if I can find something else in the greenhouse to plant out here. Found another gold medal tomato. I think I'm going to put that one in here. They're little plants, but they got roots all the way to the bottom already. So I don't know if they'll survive or not. We're trying it. We'll try it and see. I may be jumping the gun and planting them too early. So we'll just try those few and we'll see what happens. If it rains these next couple of days, that'll be a good thing. So let's see. I got the canary there. I need to plant something in that little one. Don't know what I want. Something that won't interfere with the I can't get that piece of eggplant out of there. There. I'm going to plant some eggplant seed right here in this little pot. And we'll see what happens. But what I'm wanting this one. Maybe we'll put more eggplant. Show you what I'm doing over here. gonna make rows. And I'm gonna slice this aloe vera right down the middle the best I can. Well, that's about as far as I can slice that one. Put the gooey side up. Like I said, don't forget to bring a paper towel with you, because that gooey will get on your fingers and then you can't touch the seed because they'll stick to you. And this is Chinese long purple eggplant. And they kind of stick to the aloe vera, so they stay in place. And then just cover them up. Instruction says about a half an inch. I still got a few more seeds in there, so I'm going to hold on to them. I don't know what I did with all of my markers from last year. Purple eggplant. I think most of the rest of the, I have to lose my britches, y'all. The rest of my seedlings in the greenhouse are too little to transplant, so yet. But I could go ahead and put more seeds out. Decide here what I want to plant. And move all this over. So I got part of those up to the sunflowers. Look at those volunteer sunflowers right there. See there? Come up voluntarily. Let's see. want to plant some more jalapenos. But I'll use my buckets for the jalapenos right here. What did I do with my knife? And I could just mark it on there, I guess. And then I'll probably end up with something else there. The way I usually do. What did I do with my... Gooey side up. It's all possible. I will put a tomato plant there of some kind. See if I can find a tomato seed. Look at here what I decided to do. I went and got me another slice of tomato. Look at all the seeds in there. I'll be pulling up tomatoes out of here. So that's going to be a red slicing tomato. Should have cut me more markers. Red tomato. So that's got all of those up to here. And I need more of my, what kind of seeds I can find. Where's all my tomato seeds? I know I got tons of tomato seed. Oh, here, assorted cherry tomato seed. Well, I don't have none in there. I guess I took them all out and planted them last year. Lake pole beans. Bell pepper. Little buddy, what are we doing? Huh? Gold bell peppers. I think I'll plant this other bucket here in gold bell peppers. Give me a piece of aloe vera to go over there. I can always write on the bucket, I guess. And I wanted to plant more of the grape tomatoes, I think. I'm not real sure. You're always supposed to rotate crops, so maybe I need to try something else over there instead of my grape tomatoes. Oh.
I don't know what I want to put in this one.
Maybe a jalapeno in that little one. Let's see. Get over there without getting in front of you. I only put 3 seeds in there, and that's probably too much. Put some over here in this one. They said it wasn't supposed to rain, I think, till this afternoon. That's one reason I wanted to go ahead and get these planted this morning. Ooh, that's gooey. Now, they say you can root aloe vera this way. I don't know. I've never succeeded in rooting it by cutting it and putting it in the dirt. There's the peppers planted. Of those, anyway. I need more markers. Little buddy, what do you think, huh? Let's put hot pepper. Put hot pepper on that one. Little plastic forks and spoons work great too. See, I got tons of pepper seed from last year. banana pepper seeds. Where's all my tomato seeds? I wonder if my lettuce would grow here good. I might put that around on the other side of the house. But there's all my little tomatoes. I used all of those. And I may put these. They grew real good out here last year. Got one seed in there. I should have put a piece of aloe vera there. Where'd the seed go? Take my head off here in a minute. But I'm just slicing my aloe vera and putting it down. Go ahead and put this piece over here. And these are cherry tomatoes here that I'm putting in this one. With that one little golden jubilee. Put my brandy wines back over here. Thank you. have any more in that one. And I've got Roma. Well, I planted all the seeds for Roma last year. Oops. Oh, I need more aloe vera. I guess you can see me, I don't know. But if you think about it, one reason the tomato slice germinates and comes up so well is because of the moisture in that slice, that fresh slice of tomato. It stays with those seeds until they germinate. It keeps them moist. So that's the same idea using the aloe vera, is the aloe vera is going to keep the seeds moist to where it'll help them germinate and sprout. And I've got a ripe tomato on these. Or I'll forget that I planted. Tomato. Tomato. Don't want to forget that I planted something here. Need to get one in here. got to go through and get all my empty seed packets out. Now I had package in here with steaks that I had already cut. But sure, I didn't use all of them. Which I may have already. Oh. Tomato. I know I planted something there. It's hot out here, y'all. Muggy. I don't know what they're doing over there. Something to the electrical line. See if I can mark the pepper. There. Now I don't know what else I want to plant. Because I've got these two pots. I'm not sure what I want to put there. See what I got in here. And I still got flowers I need to get out. This is a summer squash. Probably put that there. Oh, left my knife over here. But if it rains, that means I don't have to water these in. Put two seeds in there. Put two seeds in that one. need a marker. Markers. Ground is so hard I can't even stick that in there. Yellow squash, I know I've planted. If I don't mark it, I'll never know. I don't know what I want to put in these other ones. Let's go over here and look and see what I got. So I can decide what else I want to put in the ground. I think I'm gonna put a, whoops, lose my seeds. Well, I'm not sure yet. I'm gonna have to think about where I wanna put some of the rest of this. But I've still got my dish pans. I still got my dish pans right there. And I'm not sure what I wanna put there yet. And I got this stuff over here. I'm gonna put this bucket inside this cage for the tomato to come up on. Since it's hard to pull that cage out, I'm just gonna leave the cage there and drop the bucket in. That makes sense. And I'm gonna try let's see. Whoops. One of these golden tomatoes. I'm just gonna plant the seed right in there, I think. But I gotta get my little bit of aloe vera over here. And that's probably all I'm gonna plant today. Ooh, I'm getting tired. I'd love to get it all planted. Just got a couple of little pieces of aloe vera. But it doesn't take much. Just something to keep it moist. It doesn't have to be deep. I don't know if it'll get enough sun over here or not, but we'll see. We'll see if it does. If it doesn't, then we know next time to plant it all in the sun. Fold that over. It'll go in easier. What did I say the name of them was? Gold Medal Tomatoes. Oops. I'm going to plant a squash here. That's a hillbilly. Little buddy, quit. You're knocking my stuff over. He just rubs up against everything. Now you do. Maybe I'll put a red pepper there. Little buddy. You silly cat. Oh, let's see what else we can find. Get up off of my seed. Get up off of my seed. Get up off of my seed. Little buddy. Can I have my package? Can I have my package? Can I have my package? You want it back? We'll go ahead and put some squash in here. Put two in there because I don't need more than two in a pot. I can't believe how hard that dirt is. Mostly leaves. There we go. Yellow squash. So I think that's about all I'm going to plant today because I'm getting a little tired. It's a little hot out here. So I'll see y'all on my next one, y'all. Have a great day.